Charlie Munger, the billionaire investor, has some very strong words about the stock market and some young traders and investors. Just take a look. Charlie Munger says novice investors are getting lured into a bubble in a quote, dirty way by Robinhood. Charlie Munger has a warning for investors. Quote, it might end badly. Buffett's right-hand man says Wall Street is showing signs of a bubble. What's up, everybody? I am Jaspreet Singh from TheMinorityMindset.com, where money minds rethink rich. Everybody knows who Warren Buffett is. Warren Buffett is one of the most successful investors in history, and he is the person in charge of Berkshire Hathaway. Now, the person who works with Warren Buffett behind the scenes is Charlie Munger. Charlie Munger is Warren Buffett's right-hand man, and he is the vice chairman at Berkshire Hathaway. So when you see Warren Buffett doing these meetings, and you see the other guy sitting next to him, the other guy is usually Charlie Munger. Now, Charlie Munger clearly has some credibility in this space. I mean, he's a multi-billionaire and he's a very successful investor, and he has some big concerns about the stock market, especially when it comes to young people trading and investing their money in stocks. That's what I'm going to be talking about today. But before I do that, I need you to do me a quick favor and smash that thumbs up button below. And if you haven't already, join our brand new Discord server, which we call the Guac Talk community, because as we all know, guac is a symbol of wealth. In our Guac Talk community, you can chat with other Minority Mindset thinkers, where we talk about the real estate market, we talk about the stock market, we talk about cryptocurrency, we talk about money management, and we talk about all things related to building wealth and the Minority Mindset. This server, this community is completely free, so if you want to come chat with other Minority Mindset thinkers, I got the link to how you can do that in the description below. So Charlie Munger says that, quote, I think it must end badly talking about the stock market, but I don't know when. The reason why he says that he thinks that this whole stock market is building a bubble, and the reason why he says it's going to end badly, is because of young traders and investors, because of things like the GameStop phenomenon. What he says about GameStop is, quote, that's the type of thing that can happen when you get a whole lot of people who are using liquid stock markets to gamble the way that they would betting on racehorses. Now, this is kind of interesting, because when the whole GameStop phenomenon happened, you had a few people, really smart people, come onto Reddit who talked about why they thought this was the perfect opportunity to buy GameStop, because they felt like it was undervalued and they felt like it was being way heavily shorted. So if they could come in and buy the stock and push it up, that will push the short sellers out, and that could push the stock through the roof. And that's exactly what happened. Now, obviously, you had some people come in then, and once they started to see the returns, they just wanted to make some easy money. So you had the first kind of round of people that came in who thought this is a great investment. Then you had the people that came in and thought, oh, this could be a great way for me to get rich. And then you had the people come in that said, you know what, this is a great opportunity for me to give the middle finger to Wall Street. It's interesting that Charlie Munger says this, because hedge funds and other people on Wall Street have been doing this type of thing for years and decades now. But the concern now that he has is that we have a lot of people, younger traders, that don't have a lot of experience in the market doing the same thing, trying to get rich quick, or what he calls gambling. And because of that, and because of the gamification that we have of stock apps, this is creating a bubble that will end, quote, badly. What Charlie Munger says is that, quote, this frenzy is fed by the people who are getting commissions and other revenues out of this new bunch of gamblers. What he means by that is Robinhood is to blame. Robinhood is a commission-free platform which allows anybody to come onto the platform and trade stocks without paying a penny in commission. Now, this, when it first came out, was a real revolutionary ground shaker thing, because before, if you ever wanted to trade a stock, you would have to go through a traditional stock brokerage, something like TD Ameritrade or E-Trade, and you would go to one of these brokerages, and then you would be paying $10 anytime you bought or sell a stock. Before that, you'd be paying a commission, but after that came these $10 trades. So you'd come in, if you wanted to buy 10 shares or 1,000 shares of a stock, you'd pay $10, and when it was time for you to sell, you'd pay $10 again. And then these brokerages started to cut their prices down. You started to see some brokerages offer $7.99 trades, and then $6.99 trades, and then some $4.99 trades. And then Robinhood came out and they said that they were gonna let you buy and sell stocks for $0, which means you can open up a brand new stock brokerage account. You can start buying stocks and selling stocks, and you didn't have to pay a penny in commissions. This was really kind of revolutionary, because nobody understood how is Robinhood making money. Because your traditional brokerages made money in a very clear fashion. They would charge you money if you wanted to make a trade. And then if you wanted to borrow money from them, they would charge you interest. Robinhood would charge you interest if you're trying to borrow money, but they're not charging you any money if you want to make a trade. What Charlie Munger is saying is that these new apps like Robinhood are incentivizing people to gamble, because the more you trade on Robinhood, the more money Robinhood makes. Now, that might seem weird. How is Robinhood making more money off of you if they're not making any money per trade? Well, just because they're not charging you for a trade doesn't mean they're not making any money. The way Robinhood makes money is anytime you make a trade, Robinhood sells these trades to a third party. And so the more trades you make, the more money Robinhood makes. So Robinhood wants you to make more trades. They want you to be a trader. They want you to buy stocks. They want you to sell stocks because anytime you make a trade, they make more money because they have more trades to sell to this third party. And so Robinhood makes money there, but they also make money through margin. Because now if you start to make money through your trades and you start to borrow money, well, now you get to borrow money from Robinhood and then you have to pay them interest. So Robinhood wants you to be an active trader, or what Charlie Munger calls a gambler, because the more trades you're making and the more money you're borrowing, the more money that Robinhood is making. That's one of the reasons why Warren Buffett and Charlie Munger both strongly dislike Robinhood. And I think strongly dislike might be an understatement as an app for traders. Maybe they like it as an investment, I don't know. But they don't like the app as a product because it encourages people to be traders. And Charlie Munger and Warren Buffett are long-term fundamental investors. They don't like the idea of trading because they think trading is gambling. What apps like Robinhood do is they gamify the trading process because they want you to trade because that's how they make more money. So one of the ways that they do that is anytime you make a trade, they hit you with confetti. Congratulations, you just made a trade. And so it makes trading fun, it makes it into a game, and this makes you wanna trade more, it makes you wanna make more often trades, and the more times you do that, the more money that Robinhood makes. This is what Charlie Munger says is causing a bubble, because now you have a lot of people entering the market with their money and then borrowing money from Robinhood. Now they're throwing this money into the market hoping to get rich quick or hoping to make a lot of money quickly because of this trading. And he says that this is creating a bubble and this is eventually going to end and this is going to hurt a lot of people. Now, this isn't the first time that people have started trading. I mean, huge hedge funds have been trading billions of dollars for decades now, and we have seen the growth of things like high frequency trading and other types of risky trading, which kind of manipulate the market. But the difference between them and regular people is that regular people are not on Wall Street, so they don't have the same protections that Wall Street has. I mean, when Wall Street makes a bad investment, they get bailed out. When you or I make a bad investment, we lose money. But Charlie Munger didn't stop there. He also talked about SPACs and why he doesn't like them. What he said about SPACs is, quote, "I think this kind of crazy speculation and enterprise not even found or picked out yet is a sign of an irritating bubble." A SPAC is a special purpose acquisitions company, and these have blown up over the last couple of years. In 2019, these SPACs raised around $13 billion from investors. And in 2020, they raised somewhere between $76 to $95 billion. And in 2021, it's probably gonna be even higher than that. You could think of an SPAC kind of like an empty company. This empty company goes to the stock market and it goes public to raise money. Once it raises this money, it takes this money and invests in a smaller private company which wants to go public or has not gone public yet, and so invests this money into this private company, and now this private company now becomes a part of this shell empty company that is already public, and now this private company kind of indirectly becomes public and it has raised money without going public the traditional way. The advantage is it allows these smaller companies to go public without going public the traditional way and having to go through all these regulations. And so it gives more companies the opportunity to raise money. The concerns that Charlie Munger has about this is he says that it is very risky because you are taking this money and now you're investing it in companies that haven't fully proven themselves yet. And so he says that a lot of people are investing in risky assets. And because of that, he feels that young people are at risk of losing their investment. Right now, there's a lot of dollars in the market and a lot of dollars flowing into the market because over the last couple of years, we saw a lot of money printed by the United States government. On top of that, you have people that don't have to pay their mortgages and they don't have to pay the student loans right now thanks to the forbearance program. So people have more money to invest. And on top of that, some people saw the value in their homes rise like crazy. And so they've been cashing out refinancing and they have extra cash in their pockets. And some of this money is flowing back into the market. And so you have a lot of dollars flowing into the market, which has definitely caused the value of stocks to go up. And so what his concern is right now, yes, there's a lot of dollars in the market. A lot of money is flowing into the market and some people are able to make a lot of money quickly. but now people are making risky investment decisions, and because of that, and because of what he calls trading, he says that eventually, doesn't know when, but eventually this is gonna end badly. So what should you do to invest your money smartly in the market? That way you can build wealth for the long term. Well, the first thing you wanna do is you wanna get educated. If you wanna learn more, we have a free guide on stock market investing that you can read for free, which walks you through different stock market strategies and how to invest your money in the stock market. That way you can build long-term wealth in the stock market. This guide on the stock market is completely free when you sign up for our daily newsletter. And if you wanna read that guide, I got the link to how you can do it in the description below. So what should you do according to Charlie Munger to build wealth and actually make money in the stock market? Well, in a separate interview, he says there are three things that you need to do. The first thing he says is don't get caught up in trading frenzies. What he says is, quote, ride them out. So he's talking about now these meme stocks and these wild run-ups. He says that there are these periods in capitalism where you're gonna see these wild trading swings, where some people make a lot of money very quickly. And he says that, quote, I have been around for a long time and my policy has always been to just ride them out. And I think that's what shareholders do. Then he goes on to say that what a lot of shareholders actually do is crowd in buying stocks on frenzy, frequently on credit, because they see that they're going up. And of course, that is a very dangerous way to invest. So essentially what he's saying is anytime you see these meme stocks or these wild run-ups, just avoid those stocks completely and stick with your strategy. And what he says that if you made a lot of money with that, that's great. But what we know from the data is that historically, past performance hasn't been indicative of future performance. So although you made a lot of money, that's good, just be careful about the future. The second tip for investors that he has is to be aware of bubbles, because when bubbles burst, they can be painful. Back when the dot-com bubble burst in the 2000 and 2001 timeframe, the S&P 500 sank by more than 49%. When the real estate market crashed in 2007 to 2009, the S&P crashed by 57%. And so you gotta understand is that when these bubbles happen, you could see massive crashes. But what he also says is that if you face a bubble, don't panic and sell all of your stocks. Instead, stay diversified. And the third tip that he has for investors is own stocks that you know something about. What he says here is that for the average investor, the best thing for you to do is just invest in funds, index funds or ETFs that give you a broad spectrum of companies. That way now you don't gotta worry about doing the research and trying to find the perfect company. So for the majority of people, just invest in these funds. But then what he has an issue with is, quote, a lot of people think that if they have 100 stocks in their portfolio, they're investing more professionally than they are than if they had just 4 or 5 stocks in their portfolio. And he says that that is insanity, absolute insanity. According to him, he's way more comfortable owning 2 or 3 stocks which he knows about than just investing in a ton of companies that he doesn't know all about. So when he's talking about this, if you want to invest in individual companies, he wants you to be doing the research, understand the companies, and actually know about these companies than just throwing your money into a whole bunch of random companies, unless we're talking about ETFs and index funds, because he says for the average investor, he says that's the best way to go if you're talking about building wealth for the long term, because now you're just investing in the long-term health of the economy and the stock market. If you enjoyed this video, here's a video on how to make your first stock market investment that I think you'll love. And while you're at it, download our free stock market PDF. And as always, keep hustling. If you want to be a successful stock market investor, there are 7 things you need to understand. The first thing you got to understand is, what is the stock market? Why does it exist and how does it work?